Photopea comes with 19 brushes by default, and there are some useful ones included. But there might not be enough there for you. So if you've wanted to add some new brushes to your library, let's take a look at how you can do that by filling out your collection with some new, custom-made brushes. First, we need to get some new brushes. In Photopea, you can import new brushes that are in the ABR format, which is what Photoshop uses. Check the link in the description, which will take you to Matt Heath's Gumroad page, where he has a free Photoshop illustration brush set, which has some really useful brushes included. Just click on Photoshop illustration brush set, set your price at zero, or more if you'd like to be generous, and click Add to Cart. After that, go ahead and go through the checkout process. Once you get your content, you'll end up on this page, and just download the Matt Heath 8B brushes zip file. Once it's downloaded, go ahead and unzip it, and delete the zip file. Inside the folder, we've got this 0MH8B brushes ABR file. This is what we need to import into Photopea. I've got Photopea open here with a blank new project. If I select the brush tool by pressing B and right-click the canvas, you can see the default brushes we've got. There are three ways we can import brushes, and we'll use the easiest method first. Just drag and drop your ABR file into Photopea, and the brushes will be added. It's asking us if we want to save the brushes to local storage, so they'll be available every time we start Photopea. For now, hit Cancel. We don't want that yet. Now, if we right-click the canvas and scroll down, we have a bunch of new brushes added to our collection. We've got the round texture brush, which is good for getting a painterly look. And we've got the Splatter 1 brush, which gives a cool splatter effect. But as of now, these brushes are only added for this browser session. If I reload the page and start a new project, we only have access to the original 19 brushes. That's because we need to add our ABR file to local storage. So let's import our ABR file again the second way, which is by right-clicking the canvas when the brush tool is selected and clicking this little arrow here. Select Load ABR from the drop-down, and you can browse to the folder containing your brushes. Select it and pick Open. Now we get the option to store our brushes in local storage. This time, click OK. If we select the brush tool and right-click the canvas, we can see that we have our brushes imported. And when we reload the page and start a new project, select the brush tool and right-click the canvas, and all of our brushes are available. If you want to add more brushes, you can repeat this process and add multiple ABR files. What if you decide later that you don't want these new brushes anymore, and you want to go back to the default set? To do that, we need to manage the local storage and delete our ABR file. That way, it won't load the next time we run Photopea. Go to Edit and Local Storage. Here, we have a list of all the files that are loaded when we start Photopea, which, in my case, is just the 8B brushes ABR file. To delete it, we need to select it by clicking on it, and then click Delete. If you wanted to back up the files before you delete them, you can also download them as a zip file, but we don't need to do that. Right now, we can still use the brushes. They'll be included in memory until the browser is reloaded. I'll reload the browser, start a new project, and we're back to our default brushes. The last way to load ABR files to Photopea is by going to File, Open, and then selecting the file, basically the same as right-clicking and loading through the drop-down menu. Finally, let's look at how we can create our own brushes and use our custom-made brushes in our projects. Switch the foreground color to black and paint the shape you want your brush to be. It can be a stroke brush for making longer, fluid brush strokes, or it can be like a stamp in the shape of a leaf or grass. I'm going to make a simple shape for a stroke brush. Using black, I'll make the shape and then fill it in. Then, go up to Edit, down to Define New, and select Brush. Now, your brush is added to the library of brushes. Unfortunately, right now, it's kind of difficult to save your brush for use when you reload Photopea. With the brush selected, you can right-click and click on this little arrow and select Export as ABR. The problem is, this exports all of your brushes, So if you reload and import the exported ABR, you'll have two of every brush in your library. I don't know of any way to export the brush alone, other than deleting every default brush one by one, so hopefully that gets fixed in the future. Once you have your new brush, there are a few settings you can change to alter how the brush performs. Open up the Brush Properties tab here, and from here we can set the angle of the brush, which is useful while you're painting when you have a brush that is meant to be used directionally. One common problem people get with brushes is this effect when I drag my brush sideways. It leaves a jagged pattern, which I want to be smoothed out like paint would be if you dragged the brush across the canvas. This looks like you dabbed the brush over and over, and that's because that's what Photopea is doing. It's repeating the brush shape after a certain number of pixels. To smooth it out, we can change this with the spacing value. If we increase the spacing value, the gap between each placement of the brush will be larger. As we lower the spacing, the brushes will be placed closer together. If we drag it down to 1%, it will be solid with no jagged edges. We're not going to cover the other three categories, tip dynamics, scatter, and color dynamics, right now, but each of these can be used to add randomization to the placement, rotation, and color of the brushes as you draw. Experiment with them and see what you can come up with. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.